Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. We are here at Barber Motorsports Park. It's a brisk 50 degrees right now. It is Sunday, October 18th, and we are riding with Sport Bike Track Time today. Got the R6 warming up and gonna go get teched real quick and then sit around for a little bit, have the riders meeting, and then we're gonna go out on track.
I'm so proud of who I become. You might think I'm taking some lumps. Only if we talking about some, yeah. Intentions are pure.
You just gonna keep talking or are you gonna get us through?
How you doing, man?
Good, how's it going?
Going fantastic. Good to see you.
You as well?
How you been?
Good, good.
Keep the radiator?
No, engine ice. Awesome.
Alright. Sam, thank you.
Thank you.
Good to see you, bro.
You as well.
Be safe. Have fun.
Will do. Thank you. Alright guys, we got the riders meeting out of the way. Quite a few bikes here. Apparently the advanced group is pretty fast. Hopefully we're able to keep up with some of the faster guys. I know I'm not the fastest out here every day, but I try to be. Just enjoying the day. Just spent the week in Florida, so I'm a little toasty, a little dry, a little burnt. But other than that, feeling good. Weather's warming up. Should be a good day.
I was here yesterday and then it was full, so I just parked by there.
Hey.
Yeah. Well, I was here like late. It was full there.
Underway. You hear the bikes roaring in the back there. Intermediate's out, advanced is next, and then novice after that. So we're gonna go out in about 20 minutes, get a feel for the track, do a couple laps, and then come back in. I usually don't do the full first session, sometimes skip it, but limited time today. This is a good track, so I might as well. But anyways, yeah, there you go. Not a cloud in the sky. It's sunny, beautiful. First session out of the way. Only did I think about three or four laps, try to get the bike dialed in. So this isn't really a point and shoot kind of track. Majority of it is more flowing or gradual slowing. So I'm gonna mess with the suspension a little bit. Front end was pogoing a little bit where it just bounces up and down. And normally that's whenever it's too stiff, at least for me, and it can't get settled. So I usually fix that by just dialing front suspension out a little bit. Also the track is coming too. It's not as green anymore. So messing with the suspension a little bit should help.
There's one on that side, and one out on that side. So we're gonna go ahead and give that a shot, see if that works.
Another thing I like to do, which I'm sure a bunch of you do already, put a zip tie around the bottom. You don't wanna put it super tight, you wanna make sure it can move with the suspension, but then that'll tell you how much suspension you're actually using. So if you come back in and it's right there, you're only using about half of the suspension. Come back in and it's way down here, you're bottomed out. You want just a little bit of room, and then you're using the majority of your suspension without bottoming out. So whenever you bottom out, the back wheel can start lifting off the ground, or it can start hopping under heavy braking and downshifting. So, and that can create a mess of problems if you're not used to it. I'm used to it, and I'm about maxed out on the stock suspension on this bike. I have springs in here for my weight, as well as a spring on the back here for my weight. But other than that, it's a stock shock and stock front suspension. So hopefully this winter, I'll be able to put something new on it, but we'll see what finances look like.